Hi, Chuck Huber here for the State of YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to fit linear regression models with categorical predictors, and I'm also going to show you how to test hypotheses about the predictor, as well as estimate marginal predictions and do some plots afterwards. And if you stay tuned until the end, I'll show you a do file that contains all of the code that is generated by the dialog boxes along the way. So if you'd like to follow along, you can type webuse nhanes2l to download this data set that we'll be using. We're going to focus on two variables. BP systol is systolic blood pressure, and that's our continuous dependent variable. And then age group is our categorical predictor variable. And age group has a value label. I can see that here in the output of describe. And so I've typed label list age group here so I can see that there are six categories of age group, 20 to 29, 30 to 39, and so forth. So that's our predictor variable. So to fit the model, I'm going to go to statistics and then go to linear models and related and then select linear regression. I'm going to move this up over so here so I can see the results screen. And for the dependent variable, I'm going to select BP systol. And for the independent variables, because this is a categorical variable, I'm going to do something special. Rather than just select it from the list here, I'm going to click this little box that has three little dots. I call it the three-dot box here. I'm going to click that and leave type of variable factor variable selected. Okay? And then I'm only going to have one variable here, so I'm just going to specify a main effect. And here I'm going to select the variable, and I happen to know that age group is way down here near the bottom. So I'm going to select age group, and Stata will know because of the way I've specified this that it's a categorical predictor. So I'm going to click Add to Var List, and that will add that to my list of predictors in the model. So when I click OK, I can see that that's here in the list of independent variables. And notice that the dialog box has added an I dot in front of age group. And that tells Stata explicitly that age group is a categorical variable, and it will create indicators for me, so I don't have to. So then if I click OK, the dialog box will create the command. Here, regress is the command. BP systol is the continuous dependent variable. And then I have i.ageGroup. AgeGroup is the categorical predictor, and the i dot tells Stata that it's categorical. So if I look at my output, I have my ANOVA table here that displays my sums of squares and degrees of freedom and so forth. I have my observations, my f-statistic, p-values, r-squareds, and root mean squared error here at the top. And then below that I see coefficients, the coefficients for my model. So I have the intercept, it's labeled underscore cons here, an estimate of the intercept, and then I have estimates of the coefficients for each category of age group. Now notice the lowest category is left out, it's the referent group. So I have a t-test estimated for each of the categories, but if I wanted to test, let's say that I had other variables in my model and I wanted to test that the entire variable age group is, whether that entire variable is significant, I can type test parm in the command window and then type the name of that variable with the I dot in front of it. So I'm going to type I dot age group. And this will simultaneously test that all of those categories are equal to zero. So it will report one omnibus F statistic as well as a p-value. If I wanted to, I could also compare various groups to each other. So if I wanted to, for instance, compare age group 2 to age group 6, I could test whether those means are equal by typing test 2.ageGroup equals maybe 6.ageGroup. Okay, and so that will test that the difference between those means equals zero, and it will report an omnibus test F test statistic as well as its p-value. Okay, next let's talk about marginal predictions, and this is a really handy tool after you fit any kind of regression model. I'm going to go to statistics and go all the way down here to the bottom, almost to the bottom, where it says post-estimation. So I'm going to select post-estimation. And this opens the post-estimation selector. After I fit any kind of regression model, I can open the post-estimation selector and it will show me all kinds of things that I can do after I fit a model. So I can do testing, sort of like what I just did. I could have done that with the dialog box. I can test all kinds of different hypotheses and do contrasts and things. I can do goodness of fit analyses. What I'm going to do right now is marginal effects. And I'm going to keep this basic. We're going to do basic and low dimensional analysis. So I'm going to select that here and click Launch, and this will open the Margins dialog box. So here in the Main tab, I can specify whether I'm interested in a categorical or a continuous predictor, and obviously we just have the one categorical predictor, and then I can select that covariate from the model. So in this case, it knows that age group was a covariate in that model. So the dialog boxes are smart. They know what was in the previously run model. And then I can select the analysis type. I just want to do marginal means of the outcome for levels of the covariate. I can do some other things, and we're not going to go into that here today. So I'm just going to leave this more or less in the defaults and then click OK. And what this will do when I click OK, if I move this off to the side here, is the dialog box issues the command margins age group. And what this will then do is estimate marginal predictions of systolic blood pressure for each category of age group. So for instance, here where it says 20 to 29, the marginal predicted systolic blood pressure is 117.3466. For the 70 plus age group, the predicted systolic blood pressure is 148.1765. And for each prediction, I get a standard error, I get a t-statistic, a p-value, and a 95% confidence interval. So that's the margins command. Now, after I use the margins command, I can come over here and click Profile Plots After Marginal Analysis. And if I click Launch, this opens the margins plot dialog box. And this allows me to create plots of my marginal predictions from my model. So in the main tab here at the top, I'm going to select under variables that define the x-axis. I only have the one variable in my model, age group, so I'm going to select that. And let's click Submit. What Submit will do is it will run the command without closing the dialog box. So by default, what it's going to do is create a profile plot for us. So the vertical axis here is the linear prediction of systolic blood pressure. The horizontal axis here are the categories of age groups, so 20 to 29, 30 to 39, and so forth. So it's going to show us, with a little blue dot here, it's going to show us the predicted systolic blood pressure for each age group, along with a confidence interval around that prediction. And it's going to connect those dots with a line, and so that's a profile plot. If you prefer, you can actually convert this or change it to a bar chart. So I can come over here to Plot, and I'm going to change the plot type to a bar chart. Some people prefer those, and if I click Submit, now I get a bar chart with a confidence interval for each age group. And if I want to put a little gap in between those bars, I can click Bar Properties, and here where it says Bar Width, I like to change that to 0.9, and then click Submit, and that puts a little bit of a gap in between each bar. Now, some people prefer to see these displayed horizontally, so I can go back to the main tab here and check this box that says swap the X and Y axes, so it's going to transpose the graph. So when I click Submit, now it just transposes it so that the linear prediction axis is on the horizontal axis and the categories are displayed on the vertical axis. So that's just another way you could display this. And if I wanted to, I could go back and change this to a scatter plot. Click Submit. And now I can see this as a scatter plot. Another trick that I like to do with these is I like to put a little gap on either side of the, at the top and the bottom. So if you want to do that, you can go over here to Overall, the Overall tab, and select Region Properties, and then select the Plot Region tab, and here at the very top, you can increase that to maybe a large gap at the top and bottom. So watch what happens when I click Submit. So that just puts a little bit of a margin at the top and bottom of the plot. Okay, so that's how I can fit a linear regression model and do some testing and some marginal predictions and some plots. Let me close all this out and I'll show you a fun trick here so we can see the code that we generated. I'm going to come over here to the history window and I'm going to, select all. Select all, and then I'm going to right click again and then select send selected to do file editor. And so that sends all of those commands that I just generated with the dialog boxes to the do file editor, and I can save this and rerun this analysis anytime that I want. And I can also view all of these options that I used for each of the commands. Okay, so that's how we can fit linear regression models, do some testing, estimate some marginal predictions, and create some plots. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.